In this example, we want to determine the exact trig function value of tangent pi over 12 radians using the sum and difference identity seen here below. The first step in this type of problem is to determine what two angles we can add or subtract that would give us pi over 12 radians, but that also have known exact trig function values, meaning the types of angles that we see here on the unit circle, and all these are multiples of 30 degrees or multiples of 45 degrees. And that's a little bit more challenging to do when the angle is given in radians. So my suggestion would be to convert pi over 12 radians to degrees and then answer that question. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's convert pi over 12 radians to degrees. The pi's simplify out. There's 1 12 and 12 and 15 12s in 180. So 1 times 15 degrees is equal to 15 degrees. So we want to add or subtract that have known exact trig function values that equals 15 degrees. And two of them come to mind right away. 45 degrees minus 30 degrees, or 60 degrees minus 45 degrees. In both cases, the difference is 15 degrees. You might be asking whether it matters which difference we use. And it doesn't, because the result will be the same, but actually one of these will be a lot less work. So before we decide, let's take a look at our formula. For tangent 15 degrees, we're either considering the tangent of 45 degrees minus 30 degrees, or tangent 60 degrees minus 45 degrees. So either case, A will be the first angle, and B will be the second angle. So notice that we'll have to find the tangent of both angles in either case. So let's go ahead and sketch our reference triangles and look at these values before we decide. Tangent of 45 degrees is good either way, because tangent of 45 degrees is 1. But if you take a look at the tangent of 30 degrees and the tangent of 60 degrees, one of them is going to be easier to use. The tangent of 30 degrees is going to be 1 divided by square root 3. So we'll have a fraction with a square root in the denominator. But the tangent of 60 degrees would be square root 3 over 1, or just square root 3, so there's no fraction involved. So it will be a little less work if we use 60 degrees minus 45 degrees to obtain 15 degrees. So let's go ahead and use those two angles instead, even though the end result would be the same. So again, instead of using 15 degrees, we're going to use the tangent of 60 degrees minus 45 degrees. And again, this tells us that A is equal to 60 degrees and B is equal to 45 degrees. There's one more important thing to notice here. We're using a difference of two angles. And notice how the subtraction sign is the bottom part of the plus or minus symbol. So we'll have to use the lower operation on the right-hand side, meaning we'll use a subtraction sign in the numerator and an addition sign in the denominator. So let's go ahead and set this up. We're going to have tangent A, which is tangent 60 degrees, minus tangent 45 degrees, divided by 1 plus tangent 60 degrees times tangent 45 degrees. Okay, so let's go ahead and evaluate these trig functions now. Tangent 60 degrees is square root 3 over 1, or just square root 3, minus tangent 45 degrees is equal to 1, divided by 1 plus tangent 60 degrees again is square root 3, and tangent 45 degrees is equal to 1. So this is the exact trig function value of tangent 15 degrees, but let's go ahead and rationalize the denominator. So now we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator, so we'll have 1 minus square root 3 and 1 minus square root 3. Now let's go ahead and multiply this out. Let's start with the denominator. We're going to have 1 times 1, that's 1, minus square root 3 plus square root 3, that's 0, and then positive square root 3 times negative square root 3, that's going to be negative square root 9, or minus 3. Now let's take a look at the numerator. Square root 3 times 1, that's square root 3. A positive square root 3 times a negative square root 3, that's going to be minus 3, the same as we had below. And then we're going to have minus 1 plus square root 3. Let's go ahead and combine our like terms here. We're going to have negative 4 plus 2 square roots of 3 divided by negative 2. There's a couple ways of simplifying this. I'm going to break it up into two different fractions. So I have negative 4 divided by negative 2 plus 2 square root 3 divided by negative 2. So we'll have positive 2, and this will be minus square root 3. This is the exact trig function value of tangent 15 degrees using the sum identity for the tangent function. And again, depending on your instructor, you may be able to leave it in this form, but if you rationalize the denominator, it's equal to 2 minus square root 3.